The first B-21 Raider has begun taxi tests in preparation for a first flight by the end of the year, the U.S. Air Force confirmed on October 25th. This was first reported by The War Zone and later was confirmed by Air and Space Forces magazine. The main objectives of taxi tests are to determine handling qualities, performance, and system behavior that can translate into safe takeoffs, landings, and ground maneuvering in the airport environment. The taxi test is the last series of tests before the first flight, so it indicates that the airplane has already conducted a series of outdoor engine runs. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why the B-21 Raider's progress spells danger for Russia and China. Let's get into the details. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted VPN brands worldwide that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte, an industry-leading Big Four auditing firm. NordVPN provides an encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy by preventing external entry to your internet traffic, as well as enabling you to access content that's blocked based on geolocation. Best of all, with one NordVPN account, you can secure up to 6 devices at the same time. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive savings by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. The B-21 Raider is set to become the cornerstone of the bomber fleet, gradually taking over from the B-1B Lancer and B-2 Spirit. This cutting-edge bomber will offer both survivability and long-range, deep-strike capabilities, serving as a deterrent against aggression and ensuring the protection of the United States, its allies, and its partners. B-21 is being developed under the Long-Range Strike Bomber (LRSB) program. A request for proposal to develop the aircraft was issued in July 2014. On the 27th of October 2015, the U.S. Department of Defense awarded the development contract to Northrop Grumman. The B-21 designation, according to the U.S. Air Force, was chosen because the aircraft is the first new bomber of the 21st century. Well, the name Raider was chosen to represent the Doolittle Raiders, who flew a surprise attack during World War II. The U.S. Air Force plans to purchase 80 to 100 LRSB aircraft. Back in June 2021, it was revealed that the B-21's inaugural flight, initially planned for later that year, faced delays, ultimately pushing the milestone into 2022. However, several challenges extended this timeline further to 2023. The latest update on the taxi tests comes on the heels of Northrop Grumman, the manufacturer of B-21, announcing the initial ground-based engine test runs in September. This development followed the activation of the Raider's system for the first time earlier this year. All of these testing activities have been taking place at Northrop Grumman's facility, located within the Air Force's Plant 42 in Palmdale, California. 5 additional B-21s are currently undergoing production at different stages in the same facility. These 6 pre-production aircraft are anticipated to constitute the foundation of a test squadron stationed at Edwards Air Force Base in California. The next critical milestone for the B-21 is the type's first flight. Secretary of the Air Force Frank Kendall said in September, "We are still hopeful on having first flight this year." The plan is then for the first operational B-21s to start entering service in the mid-2020s. While embroiled in a violent conflict with Ukraine, Russia has not halted the development of its next-generation stealth bomber, known by its codename PAC-DA. The stealth bomber, currently in the development phase, is intended to replace Moscow's aging fleet of bombers like the Tupolev Tu-95 and Tupolev Tu-160. Recent reports reveal that Russia is actively conducting bench tests on several prototypes of the Izdalai product RF engine, which is being designed to power the PAC-DA strategic bomber. The next results have indicated that the engine meets the specified design parameters. An earlier statement from the Russian news agency TASS, citing an industry insider, indicated that a demonstration model of the long-range bomber aircraft PAK-DA is expected to be constructed by 2023. But the aircraft is still a long way off from being operational. Russian authorities anticipate the maiden flight of this aircraft to take place in 2035. China is looking to replace its Xi'an H-6 bomber, which is a Tupolev Tu-16 produced under license in China. The country is working on a next-gen stealth bomber, codenamed the H-20. Indications point to the H-20 becoming the first Chinese military aircraft to possess intercontinental range capabilities. Over the years, various models and computer-generated images have emerged on the internet, with certain ones being featured in publications administered by state-owned defense firms. Defense experts have identified a number of consistent attributes on these models, which include notched air intakes, swept-back kite-like wings, and adaptable paired tail surfaces that can transition between horizontal tailplanes and V-tails. Anticipations were high for the aircraft to make its public debut before the conclusion of 2022, but this has not materialized. The Raider is poised to be a pivotal element of America's nuclear deterrence triad in the foreseeable future, boasting the capabilities to conduct conventional strikes and fulfill various other roles. Additionally, the B-21 is just one component of a broader, highly classified long-range strike (LRS) family of systems. One confirmed part of the LRS family of systems is the stealthy long-range standoff (LRSO) nuclear-armed cruise missile, which is currently undergoing vigorous flight testing and will arm the Raider. While the exact timing of the B-21's next significant milestone, its maiden flight, remains uncertain, it is evident that progress is consistently advancing in the right direction. Next-generation bomber from Russia or China is nowhere in sight, and it's unclear if they'll even be actually comparable to the B-21 Raider. For example, while the Russian Su-57 and Chinese J-20 are touted to be fifth-generation stealth jets, they're inferior in key aspects. Russian Su-57 has an RCS of 0.05 square meters, which makes it around 500 times larger on the radar when compared to F-22, and at least 10 times when compared to F-35. Given the situation, Russia and China have reasons to be worried about the B-21 Raider's progress.
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.